finally got to meet him, and he was a lot better than they said you were, because they really didn't speak a lot, you know, highly of him. But one of the things that Frank has done for the Diocese of Fort Worth, he has served since our beginning of our reconstitution, almost from the exact beginning. And we have no other retired or active clergy who has done that. And so for, I know it's only been 6.5 years, but about 100 years he has served and driven from the north part of Tarrant County.
Southern Denton,
which is, folks, that's a long way from here. I mean, that is, and made that trip with your driver, maybe not your driver.
Oh, yes.
And back and forth, and I didn't have time to do it, and I meant to, but to count the number of miles that would be, and maybe you've done that.
Well, I ruined one car. I rolled it over 5 times.
Yeah, well, that says something, folks. And so for those years, I'm just so grateful that he has been not only a part of this congregation, but has helped you all stay where you are and grow and prosper. And in the prayers, every time I come to worship here, I'm very touched by the prayers of the people. It's not plain vanilla prayers of the people. You all pray for the ministries that you all are involved in, and that's a bunch. So you all have a great impact on this community. And through Frank's ministry and his preaching and sacramental work, he has nourished you all to continue and encouraged you to do that. So I'm so grateful to Frank and his ministry and his sweet wife, who has been here, I guess, every Sunday or almost every Sunday, and that is a real commitment to ministry on the part of that couple. They are both involved in ministry. And so as your bishop, I want to say thank you for what you have done and what you continue to do. Let me just close with a prayer that I offer. Heavenly Father, loving shepherd of your people, we thank you for your faithful servant Frank, who has been so faithful in care and nurture of your flock here at Good Shepherd. We now pray for Susan and Frank as they take leave of their care of this flock, rejoicing and giving thanks for their care of a small part of your earthly kingdom on earth here in Granbury. Be with them as they continue to grow in your love and in your service to others, and continue to hold them in your loving hands all their days. In the name of your blessed and dear Son, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
And I know y'all will do this later, but I just want to say in the church, thank you.
Susan and I were present at what became the chapel, which was at that time the Masonic Lodge. And so we're out on the side yard with Bishop Davies. We passed the hat that day and raised enough money that afternoon passing the hat to buy the building.
Wow.
And I thought, Good Shepherd had a really good start here. If you can pass that and buy a building the first day, you've done really well. So my dad became the first vicar of Good Shepherd, and when he could no longer drive the tractors out at Camp Crucis, he had to give up that job, because that was part of the duties of the rector, was to mow the 300 acres around. church down in Navasota, which had a total congregation of 25. But it remained a parish because they had one donor who always gave enough money so that they were self-supporting. And so, I can't remember the church, it was the one in Navasota.
St. Paul's,
that sounds right. But this one lady made them be a parish. So I'm not real happy about the canonical change that's in the works about making churches that aren't that don't have 50 or more for Sunday, because then my dad wouldn't have had a job. But Dad is buried just outside the door of the chapel of Good Shepherd. And my mother is her ashes are sprinkled on top of my dad because she said she wanted to grow posies. She hasn't grown a darn thing. She has killed everything that I have planted. She could touch anything when she was alive and make it grow, but just lost the touch somehow. It is my plan, or Susan is my plan, to have our ashes put on the side of the grave where my mother would have gone if she hadn't been cremated, and we'll both be cremated and have a little plaque saying, here are the ashes of Susan and her boyfriend. But when I came to the Good Shepherd, I had all kinds of ulterior motives in terms of a real investment in seeing that the congregation was a continuing thing. I had no idea about how long I was going to be there. I had this mythical idea that this court case was going to take about a year. I also believe in unicorns, rainbows. Of course, once I got there, you reached out and embraced Susan and myself, and there's nothing more that we could do but embrace you back. And so it's become something that transcends friendship. You know, we are more than friends with you. We care about you very, very deeply, and we will miss being with you on a regular basis. But as Con put in the newsletter, we have our emails in the newsletter and our personal cell phones, and we would love to hear from you. You may hear from us. You just never know about that. But it has been a wonderful time for us. Once I destroyed my first car driving home from Good Shepherd, Susan became my permanent chauffeur. I have never driven down here since. So I rehearsed the sermons on the way down, so she gets to hear it read at least twice before I arrive. So there's a certain amount of editing that goes on during that ride down. If there's ever a sermon you don't like, I take total responsibility for it. If it touched you in some way, then thanks be to Susan. Yeah. I really am at a loss for words in trying to describe the relationship that I feel with you. But what I feel is that something is coming back to me. That it's not a one-way thing, and that you have actually gone out and embraced us too. And that energizes us and motivates us and keeps us yearning to come back and be in your presence. But I am very excited about your future now. I'm very proud of you. I have never been with a senior warden so long in my life. I think this may be a church record. Make sure it goes in the Episcopal Church annual somewhere. It's been great working with Ian. The the ground rules that I made when I came to Good Shepherd was that I would not be involved in any meeting, nor would I solve any conflicts, because I believe you are the church, and you don't need someone with a collar directing you in all of your activities. That's not really the ministry of a priest anyway. Unfortunately, many priests feel like they have to do that, and I feel sorry for congregations who are led by a priest that feels like he or she has to direct everything. My understanding of the church is that the baptized are the church, and that the priests have a sacramental, sacerdotal responsibility to minister to the ministers of the church. That you are the basic, boots on the ground ministers, and that my job is to facilitate and to preside over the sacraments which have been entrusted to me. I think you've done a wonderful job of managing yourself without some type of heavy-handed oversight. I don't know how we could have survived as a viable worshiping community without the ministry of Manette, though. Music is such an integral part of offering praise and worship to God. And Manette is very good at looking at the liturgy of the day, what are going to be the lessons, and then finding music which complements that. And so, thank you very, very much for that.
Here, here.
And that's longer than my sermon. Thank you very much.